Traveling from Chennai to Pondicherry was awesome. But ab bari hai to check out some eco-friendly experiences closer to my home, Delhi.
So I've come to a lot of organic cafes, but main se kabhi khet mein nahi aayi hu khana khane. And it's such a beautiful, nice, sunny day today. This will be something different.
In cities where most people don't own farms, concepts like farm clubs, where you basically own a chunk of land in the suburbs for a nominal subscription fee, is absolutely amazing.
So I've just been recommended the Gobi Ka Parantha and I'm starving, so I'm dying to try it. I can't believe 10 minutes pehle ye gobi ek plant thi and now it's a parantha.
The idea behind farm to table or farm to plate is to consume local organic produce so that you know exactly what goes on behind cultivating your food.
As I move forward in my journey, I'm beginning to realize that there are so many little things that one can do to play their part in trying to solve the world environmental problems. And this farm to plate is such a great concept. And this space is doing a really good job of it. This place was awesome. If you guys want to have a nice Sunday brunch, I think ye jagah check out karna to banta hai. Now I'm super excited and super charged to hit the road again. I've got some very cool places planned around the trip and I'm going to have lots of fun and learn a lot in the process.
Hello MG.
Hi, how can I help?
Please open the sunroof.
Love about Delhi, like it's definitely one of my favorite places in India, but unfortunately the pollution levels are just going a bit crazy with every passing year. But this car, it has a filter, which is the PM 2.5 filter, which I think is an absolute must for a place like Delhi. I think every car should have it. The benefits of anything that is organic start long before we get to lay our hands on the item. When toxic material is not used in the farming process, it's better for the soil, the groundwater, the workers on the farms, the factories who are otherwise exposed to chemicals, and for your body as well. So I'm at this beautiful property called Maan Bagh, which is in Karnal, and it's run by a wonderful lady, Mrs. Renuka Maan. And she's going to tell us a lot about organic farming today. So I can't wait to hear from her. Hi, Sashrikal ma'am. How are you?
I'm good.
Really nice to meet you, ma'am. Yeah. So ma'am, what is your philosophy when it comes to organic farming?
So organic is a word which I don't use in my farming. I say I'm chemical free or natural.
Okay.
Because organic is a very, very vast term and it means a lot. It means the air, the water, the soil. We can manage the soil, we can manage a bit of the water, you can't manage the atmosphere at all.
What inspired you to take this route?
Yeah, that was a very long story. They say when, you know, things happen, it happens.
Right.
So I'd gone for a fair in Delhi, which I wanted to go buy boots for myself.
Yeah.
And I'd seen my cousin wear it and I said, wow.
Yeah.
And she told me, last day, last hour, go and see it. And she, I couldn't find that shop, but yeah. I managed to meet a doctor in Punjab University who had started organic farming there.
Oh, wow.
So I got my lead from her. I kept in touch with her and she set me up.
Wow. Amazing.
So that's how it started.
Wow. Amazing. I can see your lovely dog here.
Yeah.
What did you name? What did
Caesar.
You say? Caesar. Hello, Caesar.
Renuka ma'am just told me how they harvested their crop just a few weeks back and they're already preparing for the next season.
I've noticed that when you have seen your crop being grown and then when you eat it, it just tastes 100 times nicer. Like today the gobi ka paranthas blew my mind, you know. It was beautiful.
Yeah, anything which is fresh and right out of the field,
yeah,
it's got a different taste. You can't get that.
Yeah, you can't. It's unparalleled. It's really, really lovely. I've come to realize that every time you sit at home with a plate of food in your hand and you watch TV in front of you and you're mindlessly eating, I can't believe how much we take for granted the food we eat. Today, after seeing this farm and seeing the sarso grow and seeing how it becomes mustard seeds and things like that, I've come to realize how much you need to love and respect the effort and the care and the enormous amounts of hard work that goes into creating the food that we actually eat. I'm going to become a mindful eater from now. I think this is a very beautiful lesson I've learned today.
In the next leg of my trip, we're going to the beautifully planned city of Chandigarh. Over there, I will learn about the school concept called permaculture at this wonderful farm near Chandigarh.
Chandigarh काफी cool है वैसे. It's one of India's cleanest and best planned cities.
Manisha and her husband started Ananda in 2010 while living in Mumbai. Over this decade, they've transformed a barren piece of land into a haven for people interested in permaculture. I can't wait to meet them and find out more about this unique farming concept and their journey.
Hello, how are you? Hello. Welcome to Ananda.
Thank you so much. How are you?
I'm well.
Who's this little thing?
This one is Bachu. She's the latest addition to our family.
Cute.
Manisha is a permaculture pioneer in India. She uses her expertise to write various articles and host a bunch of sessions for people who want to learn more about this sustainable way of farming.
So I'll be completely honest, मुझे permaculture के बारे में कुछ नहीं पता. So please tell me from the start.
Kriti, permaculture is permanent agriculture.
Okay.
You know, it's a system of food production, but it mimics nature. It's a place where all sorts of trees, plants, flowers, species, birds, insects, they all come together to form a highly productive and resilient system.
Wow.
It's at complete contrast with how food is grown these days, which is monoculture and heavily dependent on external inputs like fertilizers and chemicals. So not only is this place organic, but it's like a forest, right? That's why it's also called a food forest.
Wow. So completely diverse, yeah?
Yes,
that's the aim.
Yeah.
Very, very nice. Oh my God, is that bengan? It's the nicest looking bengan ever.
Why don't we pick some of it?
Yeah.
Yep. All the big ones you can pluck out. Ye nikalo.
Is there a technique? Should I twist?
No, just lift it up. And then bas.
One of the main reasons for them to open up this farm to visitors was to educate them about permaculture. Unlike a normal farm, a permaculture farm mimics nature and has a lot of diversity. So I understand that permaculture is about diversity, but why is that important?
It's important because, you know, diverse species come together to have a lot of resilience. For example, in a monoculture, a pest has unlimited supply of one type of food. Mm-hmm. So it goes crazy, it goes out of control. Mm. But when there is intercropping and diversity, the pest will also remain in check. And every pest will have a predator in that ecosystem.
Wow, so right? It keeps everything in balance.
Absolutely. Like, it keeps everybody balanced and it keeps the ecosystem to be highly productive. And that's how nature works.
That's true.
You'll never see monoculture in nature. You'll never see a forest in which only one thing is growing.
Right, right.
So we are trying to mimic nature and work with nature. And then nature gives you back by leaps and bounds. We grow over 120 different food crops here, Kriti.
Yeah, yeah.
And I can put a nice meal on the table that's almost entirely grown by us.
Wow.
Apart from salt and garam masala, every other ingredient in my meals is grown here at Anand.
It's so wonderful to see innovative ideas like permaculture enter traditional fields like agriculture. And it's so empowering to see a person like Manisha who is literally at the core of this movement. I'm just so glad to have met her.
I can't believe I did this.
Wow. Beautiful. I always thought that having a farm is good for the environment and that is enough. But now I understand that diversity is key. I guess this is what learning is all about. This whole trip feels so strange to me at times. I feel like I've learned a whole lifetime's worth of things in a minute. Some vacations help you relax, some help you connect with family and friends, and some vacations just feel unfamiliar. I'm sure a day will come when this trip ends, but for now, I can't wait to experience what the road that lies ahead has in store for me.
If you want to learn more about ecotourism and if you want me to explore more such places, then please share this video with all your friends. And don't forget to comment below and tell me about your experiences. I'd love to read it.